this video is about surface excavation, which is how a great percentage of operators use GPS machine control. The more advanced guys might play around with digging for lines and creating your own surfaces, lines and things to create your own 3D surface. But the most common and the easiest way to use machine control is basically digging from a finished surface. So in this subdivision, for example, there's a surface for the wetlands, which is the finished surface of the topsoil and the rock and everything that's finished. And depending on what you're excavating, you excavate relative to that surface. Same here in the subdivision, we've got a road that's been dug out, boxed out. Your finished surface will be your finished surface of your asphalt, up to your curb, your nature strip, your footpath, and then whatever the batter does on that side, and whatever the batter does on that side, that all becomes your finished surface. So if you're digging to a surface in a road and the pavement's 300mm thick, you simply change that surface to minus 300 and then it will tell you how far away you are from that surface as you excavate. If you're in the nature strip, you might want to be 200mm or 8 inches below finished surface. So when you're in the nature strip, you drop that surface, instead of finished, you go minus 200mm or minus 8 inches and then it will show you how close you are to that surface. So looking at the screen there, it says out of design. Don't panic, it's probably because the surface is in the file but you just haven't displayed it. You don't want to have too much being displayed in there if you don't need to. Some projects will have 5-10 different surfaces depending on who set the file up. So to get to the file menu, press that little button up here if you've got a GX55, go to your file surfaces. So you can see here I've got three surfaces. None of them are being shown because they're all blank over on the right hand side here. I'm in stage 23 at the moment, so I'll highlight stage 23, click show, you'll see a tick box appear. Click OK. And that'll say that it's still out of design because I haven't told it which one's my active surface. So you can display as many surfaces as you like. In another version of this project, we've had the stage 23 for the road works, and then we had a separate surface file for the wetlands. So you can show as many as you like, but showing them is one thing. The other thing is actually using them as your active surface. To do that, you go to your file menu, active surface. At the moment, there's only 23 displayed because that's the only one that I showed in the surfaces menu. If I wanted to display all those other surfaces, then I would display them in surfaces and then I would see them here. So if I go to 23, now I've got a surface file which I'm in. You can see I've got a measurement down there and I've got a depth that's shown on the screen there basically. So just recapping, if I go to file surfaces and I want to show that one, tick. Show that one, tick. Go OK. Still hasn't changed my active surface, it's just simply brought those in so I can make them an active surface if I want. So if I go file, active surfaces, I've now got an option to select any of those three. If you want to turn surfaces off, so you only want to display the one you're working on or you want to display none at all, go back to your surfaces menu, highlight, show will untick it, highlight, show will untick it, and you will not be able to unshow your active surface. You've got to make it not active and then unshow it. That's a bit of a trick. So the show button disappears, you'll notice, when I click on 23. That's because it's currently the active surface. So if I want to go back in there and not show 23, you need to go file, active surface, none. And then if I go back into file surfaces, that show button will appear. I'm gonna leave it there, but I was just showing you how to do that. File, active surface, 23. So you can see there, once the screen catches up down the bottom there, I'm sitting right in the future curb and channel. If I just slow across there a little bit to the left, the height's been taken from wherever that red arrow is. Red triangle, sorry. So that red triangle is where my height's been taken. So, better example over here. If I've got my bucket right, say right about there. I'll just try and get the left edge of the bucket pretty close to zero. The middle of the bucket's probably cut a little bit. And the right edge of the bucket's going to be filled. So using my shortcut key on the top right, or pressing and holding on the bucket, move control to the right. If I move my height point to there, you can see it says up 140 mil. If I press and hold back to the middle, you'll see it says go down about 20 mil. You see a little gap there, and if I use my shortcut key to scroll across to the left, press it a couple of times there, you'll see it's pretty close to finished surface. So it's very important where that red triangle is when you're excavating using GPS machine control. In the top screen, you'll see a crosshair on the bucket. That's for your steer. So that's telling you how far off a line you are. That's very different to the height triangle, which is shown on your bucket. And if you forget which one's which, just try and remember that you can't see that one when you're looking at the section view. So looking at the section view, you're looking at how high you're digging. And from the top of the machine, if you're looking down on the machine, you can't tell what height you're at. You can only tell what location you're at. So crosshair up the top, if you've got that selected, is for your steer. And the bottom is the most important for bulk excavation, which is where your reference point is for your excavation. So over here we've got a subgrade, which is eventually going to be asphalted to about that height there. That's going to be where the finished asphalt is. This pavement, I can't remember now, but I'll go down to the subgrade. Looks like it's about 300 mil, might be 320 mil pavement. So if I go up to that finished surface, that's where the finished asphalt's going to be. Slew across out of the nature strip here, that's where the curb and channel is, that's where the nature strip is, and the footpath's going to be further up to the right. So if I was here on a big excavator and I was bulking out this road or a grader and wanted to know where the subgrade height was, I would simply adjust this surface down to my depth of pavement. So if I've got a 300 mil depth of pavement, I would change this to -0.3. So if I click on that green bar down the bottom, you've got your elevation set point down here. If you click in there, it'll allow you to change that to the minus buttons over here, -0.3, okay. Okay, that drops that whole surface down to -300. You've got your vertical offset shown here, so it's nice and easy to remember. And that's saying that at the moment I have to go down 300-ish mil to get to my -300 offset dig. So that would be basically your excavation for this project, which looks like it's absolutely spot on for this job. So that's how you dig to surface. You might have a different offset when you're over in the nature strip, so you might only dig out -200 when you're up here. So you could change that to -0.2. Well, some operators like to leave this on zero. And then when they're here, they'll look for +200 in the nature strip. And when they're down here, they'll look for +300 in the excavation. Depends on how you want to do it. So that's basic surface excavation, which is very useful and very common. Hope you enjoyed it.